So hopefully this is done in 12. Oh. This thing is just off. The fan's not making any noise. It's not turning back on. Hey guys, how are you all doing? If you're new here, welcome. My name is Krazy Ken, and sorry, I just can't be interrupted right now. I'm in the middle of finishing this thing up quick. Just one sec. Yes, all right. I am proud to report that I've officially accomplished nothing because the computer isn't even on. I'm having a little bit of a weird issue with this thing that's actually been going on for several months, but it's not a showstopper. I can just kind of ignore it and get on with my life, but it's still driving me crazy. Macs aren't perfect. Well, who would have thought? So before I just ramble about it, let's see if I can actually recreate the issue. So let's power it up. It's on, I can hear the fan. It normally isn't quite this bad. It doesn't even seem to be, it's probably gonna automatically restart any moment now. Seems to be stuck. Oh, hang on. I think it's doing something. Boy, that M1 MacBook Air is just sitting back there with no problems. It's just cruising through life. But hey, this thing is over 7 years old. Like, I've used the crap out of this little guy. But, okay, it doesn't look like it's doing anything, so I'm gonna hard shut it down. All right, it's off. I'm gonna turn it back on. Here we go. Okay, this is weird. It's normally not this bad. Maybe it needs some juice. I'm gonna go get a power cord. Oh, of course, right when I walk away, it's on the screen. So I have FileVault turned on, which means I have to authenticate before the rest of the boot up finishes. So let me just do that here. So now it's loading up. What normally happens is it automatically reboots. Sometimes when I turn it on or when it's in sleep mode, and I try to wake it up, it just freezes on the lock screen and I have to hard shut it down. I boot it back up, it then reboots in the middle of the reboot, and then it like chugs along for like 4 minutes or so until it gets back to my desktop. So sometimes I'll get an error that pops up and it says sleep-wake failure, something kind of like that. So I thought the battery was having issues. So I got it replaced with this third-party newer tech battery thanks to my buddies at MacNition. They did a super fast turnaround. And oh, there it is, it popped up right there. I'll get back to the battery story in a sec. So it says your computer was restarted because of a problem. And I go to report and it says, system sleep-wake experienced a problem. Sleep-wake failure in EFI. So something is causing this issue, and before I looked into it, I kind of just stupidly assumed it was the battery because the battery was coming on 7 years old, so I got it replaced. But when this issue persisted after I just got the battery replaced, that's when I got a little freaked out because I just spent money on a battery replacement thinking it would fix this issue, and it didn't. Overall, it's still good to have a new battery because it'll actually just help in the long run with some other things. I've actually noticed it does stay on for longer because on my older battery, sometimes like when I'm at 7%, just milking this thing, it'll just go into sleep, but now it doesn't do that. So the new battery does help, but still it doesn't fix the main issue that I'm experiencing, which is this load of crap. Here's the weird thing. On macOS Big Sur, when I was beta testing that on this computer, it never had this issue. So I'm wondering, how the hell do we fix this? We already put in a new battery and didn't do shit. So I'm just thinking maybe we gotta nuke it. Maybe there's some bad software on here causing an issue. So I think we just gotta wipe everything out and start fresh. Hey, it's been a while since we've had a good old-fashioned computer problem on Krazy Ken's Tech Misadventures. Oh yes, this truly is like old times. So if you're ready, and I sure hope you are because we're already going down this rabbit hole, we're gonna boot into recovery mode and try to fix this thing. And as you know, because this is the Krazy Ken curse, this simple little task is gonna end up taking my entire day, and I'm just gonna be happy as a pig in shit. My therapist told me I need to smile more. So we're gonna do that. I'm gonna say send to Apple. I doubt it does anything. I broke it. And hey, you know, if it just bursts into flames, I'll just keep using that MacBook Air. Hell, that thing makes no noise, has crazy battery life, and is insanely fast. If you didn't see the episode where I tested it out, check it out. That thing is baller. All right. Back in a sec. Okay, so before we nuke this machine, I just want to make sure all the data is off of it. Now, this is my field computer, so I don't have data on here that's usually just by itself. Usually I'm always working with data that's on the cloud or whatever. But there were some local files on here, so I'm just putting those on Dropbox to make sure they're backed up. Got about 130 more files. We're going at about 1600 kilobytes per second. 32 minutes. Oh, good. Well, when you're 10 stories underground, what more speed could you ask for? Oh, I'm sad. 14 more minutes, 13 more minutes, 14 more minutes on the sink. And then 13 minutes, we can nuke this thing. Well, it just changed to 2 hours. It's usually way quicker. But, oh well, hey, I'm not going anywhere. I've been down here for years. Still not 100% sure why. I'm sure someone will look at all my past tech video logs and figure out the lore as to why I'm down here and rescue me. That'd be great. It's cold down here. Okay, what wise guy touched my settings? How long has it been set to limit automatically? I do not remember ever doing that. All right, 2 eons later, we're done. So we're booting into recovery mode here. We could maybe do just a reinstall without reformatting, but honestly, I've been thinking of nuking this thing anyway, just to kind of keep it fresh. I mean, why not? Most of my stuff is in the cloud. It'll just sync over. Okay, so let's log in. And here we go. So again, we could just do the reinstall, but I just feel like we're just gonna be right back here later. So let's just nuke the sucker. Okay, so let's unlock the disk. Man, it's taking its sweet time. Ooh. Well, this isn't really like a speedy environment. It's like a super lightweight kind of system, the recovery mode. Okay, so now after the peach ball goes away, gosh darn it. There we go. All right, we're making some progress. Now we're cooking with shampoo. I don't know. All right, partition. I'm gonna go to the partition sheet here. So I think if we just, there we go. Erase macOS, it'll permanently erase all data stored on it. You cannot undo this action. APFS, erase volume group. What the hell did I just click? Oh shit, I thought that was a menu. I didn't know I was actually erasing anything when I clicked that. I have no idea what erasing a volume group is. I think that's the data volume and the non-data volume. It makes two volumes for like security reasons or something like that. I don't know. Yeah, okay, well, I guess that's what I meant to do. It's my own computer. Sometimes, especially when I'm just transmitting for you guys here, just having fun, sometimes I'm just not very careful with what I click. If I'm working on someone else's computer, rest assured, I'm much more careful. Son of a it failed. What? The volume macOS couldn't be unmounted because it's in use by process 713. Kernel extension cache, couldn't unmount disk, operation failed. yes, isn't that a delight? Can we unmount and erase even if it's encrypted? I mean, I guess we could. Failed to unmount because it's current, you son of a. All right, well, let's just click it again. Okay, well, you're gonna play hard to get. So we're gonna quit out of disk utility and we're gonna try that again. It is in use. Okay, well, let's just try erasing it again. Format is APFS. Son of a. Something is really effed up on here. Like, the shutdown button doesn't work. The reset button doesn't work. Let's try quit. Restart. Oh my gosh, dude. Something is really effed up on this computer. Okay, well, we're just gonna do a hard shutdown. Forgive me for this computer. Sorry to have to be like this. Man, those fans are loud. I mean, they're still pretty quiet compared to like a lot of other computers I've heard, but yeah, compared to that MacBook Air, ooh, you're a noisy bastard. all right, wow, this thing is getting hot too. Man, it's crazy how these Intel systems are noisy and hot, and those M1 ones are like quiet and cool, and they're much faster. Oh man, we've come a long way. All right, I'm gonna try doing it in a race without mounting. I mean, the number one error I get when doing disk utility operations is like could not unmount volume, excuse me. So that's usually the main issue is the unmounting. There we go, clean as a whistle. So now we can exit out of here and go to reinstall Catalina, continue. And hopefully this is just a basic software issue after I already spent money on the battery replacement though. Hopefully it's just this simple and boom, we're done. So, all right, we're going to install now. Oh, we just time traveled 13 minutes. It's gonna do this part and then it has to do that second phase where it's gonna reboot a few times. So hopefully this just works and we'll test it out. Stay tuned. Okay, we have successfully rebooted. This is going way smoother than reinstalling El Capitan that one time. Who would have thought you had to change the date and time to make that work? Anyway, yeah, no errors so far. We're in the second part of the installation. This part will probably take a half hour. So thankfully for you, we can just time travel through that and you don't need to witness all that. But for me, I'm in real time and I have to sit through the whole gosh darn thing. But I'll make it fast for you. Get ready to skip ahead. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Boom, we're already down to 12 minutes remaining. See, time travel is real. Man, those fans are just cranking. Dude, this thing is hot. Oh man. Oh well. So hopefully this is done in 12. Oh. Oh. It did this to me before. I don't know if it's supposed to, but it just turned off. Hello, McFly. Oh yeah, this thing is just off. The fan's not making any noise. It's not turning back on. Oh, hang on, it just did by itself. I'm just not gonna touch it, because apparently, well, the Krazy Ken curse is real. I touch it, I curse it, I have no idea. All right, well, let's just let it do its thing, I guess. And bam, 1 minute remaining. Well, hopefully. We all know estimated times aren't always telling the truth. And hopefully this is it. Progress bar is moving along quick. And here we go. Setup ass assistant is loading. And we're gonna start fresh. All right, Afghanistan. No, United States, thank you for showing up. All right, so I have some more stuff to set up, but I'm not gonna bore you with all that, so see you in a minute. So it looks like we're gonna be starting over because the iCloud thing wasn't working, but then it wouldn't let me go back and just set up a local account with my own name. It was pulling in like my contact info and name from my iCloud and it won't let me type in a username. So it was being kind of stupid. I just typed my password into my network name field. I need more sleep. I need a lot more frickin' sleep. All right, let's try this again. See you soon. Ah, here we are on the fun question. Dark mode, as always, because I was born in the dark. So, setting up, here we go. So now the ultimate test. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna yank the power and put it into sleep mode and let it sit, I don't know, maybe overnight. Power cord, goodbye. I'm going to sleep this thing and we'll come back to it later and see if it has the problem. Okay, so now it's the moment of truth. I let this sit overnight, not plugged in. It's been about 15 hours. So theoretically, we should be able to open it up and everything should be fine. If it locks up, then I guess the next resort is to install Big Sur, but Krazy Ken curse, please just go easy on me this one time. Hopefully this is just a quick, simple issue and we can all get on with our lives. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Hey, so far so good. But sometimes when I log in, there could be some issues too. So I'm just gonna make sure, dot your I's and cross your T's. Boom. There we go, battery is at, show percentage, 100%. Good, okay, well, I think, so yeah, I guess that's all it was, just some kind of Catalina bug conflicting with something in my previous installation. So we formatted the drive and, hey, we're good to go now. So, well, that was pretty easy. If there's any other issues that do come up, I do post that stuff on Twitter. I'm actually pretty active on Twitter, so go ahead and follow me on there for some good tech fun. But yeah, I do want to install Big Sur on here when maybe .1 or .2 comes out, so maybe I'll do an installation sensation for that as well, just as a quick little thing, because I do like Big Sur. I just am very hesitant to update right away. I've been screwed before. Well, I guess that's it. That was a simple one. If you haven't seen my M1 speed test episode, definitely check that out. and also check out all the other cool episodes I do on my other show, Krazy Ken's Tech Talk. Lots of fun to be had, and feel free to subscribe and stick around for more cool tech stuff coming up. Got some cool plans in store. So, thanks for sticking with me. You guys helped make this easy. I think it was our positive energy that made this thing work. Now I just have to migrate all my data back on here. You don't want to see that. That's boring. Anyway, thanks for sticking with me. Catch the Krazy and pass it on.